The Great Barrier Reef is recognised all over the world for both its stunning beauty and its environmental diversity. That's why the International Maritime Organization declared the Great Barrier Reef and Torres Strait particularly sensitive sea areas. Bulk exports and the import of fuel and manufacturing resources are crucial to Australia's economy. 11 ports operate close to the Great Barrier Reef, and the shortest navigational route from these ports to Asia and the Pacific runs through the Great Barrier Reef. The region is remote and very demanding for mariners, who can encounter confined waters, strong tidal streams, and shallow reefs and shoals. Located in Townsville, Reef VTS is the coastal vessel traffic service for the Great Barrier Reef and Torres Strait. It is one of the largest coastal vessel traffic services in the world, monitoring some 6,000 kilometres of coastline from Cape York to Sandy Cape. Reef VTS improves navigational safety and reduces the risk of shipping incidents, which results in a reduced risk of damage to the marine environment. The centre is staffed around the clock by VTS operators who monitor and communicate with vessels using land-based and satellite systems.
The Reef VTS has been extremely successful. Since its introduction in 2004, there's only been one grounding. It represents a 90% reduction.
Reef VTS provides essential and timely information to ships to assist in their onboard decision making. Some 5 million position reports are processed each day. Shipmasters are expected to make the best use of the information Reef VTS provides. However, by law, the shipmaster remains responsible for the safe navigation of their vessel.
My role, I have a command of all of this vessel, but I'm not so familiar in this area, so we have to cooperate with the pilot.
Australia's coastal pilotage system for the Torres Strait and sections of the Great Barrier Reef requires all ships greater than 70 metres in length to carry a coastal pilot. These pilots provide local knowledge to assist ships with navigating through some of the narrow and complex shipping routes. Once a pilot boards a vessel, they notify Reef VTS and provide any additional information about the vessel's transit, such as the route they intend to take.
And draft aft 8.98, over.
Romeo, sir, thank you for the report.
The ship and Reef VTS communicate through a coastal VHF radio network. The vastness of the Reef VTS area means that VHF is limited in some remote areas, in which case vessels can communicate via email through Inmarsat C systems. To assist an operator in their role, Reef VTS uses automated decision support tools to monitor the transit of individual ships. After looking at the situation, the operator may decide to intervene with the ship to confirm their intentions, or in a situation where the ship is approaching danger, they can provide navigational assistance to avert a grounding.
Equipment indicate that you are standing into shallow water.
Roger, I can confirm I'm aware I'm in shallow waters. My deepest draft is 4 metres.
Romeo, sir, that is all received and understood and acknowledged.
Reef VTS plays an important role in incident response. They alert and provide relevant information to the emergency response teams by monitoring the situation and communicating with the ships involved. As an additional measure to protect the environment, AMSA has introduced an underkeel clearance management system into the Torres Strait. Underkeel clearance is the acceptable distance between the bottom of the ship's hull and the seabed. Reef VTS assists the pilot by monitoring and providing underkeel clearance information when requested or if alerted by an escalating situation. We've been entrusted with guardianship of one of the world's great natural treasures. Through Reef VTS and other protection measures, the Australian and Queensland governments are working with the shipping industry to safeguard the reef for the future.